Hi, everybody. My name is Claude Diamond. I love sales. I think it's the million-dollar skill, if you know anything about me. And someone brought to my attention that my book, The Mentor Teaches the Gut Sales Method, which is a business novel. I like novels better than academic books because it's just fun to read a story, especially one with a really happy, successful a ratio Alger type ending. That's a happy ending. So I thought I'd just read the opener of my book to you and let you enjoy it. It's available on my website, clauddiamond.com. Or if you want an excerpt or part of it for free, just give me a call. Anyway, let me read it to you guys and just the opener here. When I was a kid, I remember people would tell me to shut up. Now they pay a lot of money to listen to me. Go figure. Sleazy, liar, big mouth, annoying, nuisance, loud, obnoxious, exaggerator, or all words describing salespeople. Actually sounds like the beginning of the story of Snow White and the decrepit dwarfs. Some other descriptive favorites are manipulative, cheap polyester suits, and the infamous Willie Loman from Arthur Miller's Death of a Salesman. These are all terms that are conjured up when we mention the word sales, salesmen, and salespeople. Think about it. What proud mother or father in their right mind would exclaim on the birth of their offspring, "Here is my son, daughter, the future salesperson." Yep, you're right. It just ain't going to happen. Having said all this, I've had many sales jobs, from running the blue light special at Kmart to selling hot dogs in the South Bronx, the Bronx, for Swift Premium. Good company. The training in sales ranged from nil to sophisticated and included expensive seminars. I was good, but I was not making the money I envisioned, and I grew to dislike the way many prospects were treating me. They would keep me waiting in their offices while I was reading their old boring trade magazines, even though I had a firm appointment. Eventually, they would grant me an audience. Heck, the Pope would be easier to meet. Sometimes I'd get an order, sometimes just a BS session, and other times, disrespect. After all, I was only a salesperson. I found myself making excuses not to go out and make presentations. I became a slacker because I just wasn't feeling fulfilled. I mean, how the heck do you motivate yourself every day when you get up in the morning? Oh boy, he said to himself, today I go out and have prospects and buyers crap all over me again. What fun. In light of the above, I did meet salespeople who loved what they were doing, had their own business, and best of all, they were making unbelievable money while having control and fun with their lives. I was envious, and I wanted what they had: security, self-esteem, and, of course, the big bucks. And for those of you who disdain making money and just want to make the world a better place, read no further. I like making money. I think you can be a better person when you have money. You can be philanthropic. You can volunteer. You can donate to causes you believe in. But when you're broke, you don't help anyone, including yourself and your family. Sorry, that wasn't in the writing, but I thought I'd throw that in there. I had attended all the modern sales seminars, read all the classic books and recent bestsellers. What I found for the most part was these guys were all saying the same thing, but in different ways about presentations, closing, and the usual dog and pony shows blended with tons of hype and motivation. This stuff was older than Methuselah, an old guy in the Bible. I wanted to learn, but these methods didn't just seem to work for me on a long-term basis. I thought that I needed a sales mentor coach if I was ever going to get out of this sales rut. Someone who had achieved the success that I wanted and who had the right to teach me, because he was doing it correctly, all the way to the bank. I wanted to find the best salesperson in the world who would teach me his method of success. Eventually, my search was over because I found the person who gave me the sales tools, the concepts, and methods to make as much money as I wanted. I call this the gut sales method because it made me confident. It allowed me to work smart, have a blank check in front of me for the rest of my life. Sales gives you freedom. This novel is based on that mentoring relationship, the lessons learned, and how my life was never the same again. When I wrote my first book, The Mentor: A Story of Success, I introduced Gregarious Max the Mentor in a readable, motivating, and hopefully memorable parable. Based on your favorable response, you guys, thank you. You have bought a lot of my books. Thank you again. I have written The Mentor Teaches the Gut Sales Method in the same style, hopefully with the same results. Remember, Sales is the million-dollar skill. And this is my introduction to my book, The Gut Sales Method. It's a story about this guy. He's down on his luck. He can't sleep at night. He's behind in his bills and everything like that. He hates his job. His boss is just a horrible person. And then he meets this sweet old guy who's just the world's greatest sales person. And he teaches him how to sell and takes him through this journey, this adventure. And he learns the different techniques of the gut sales method. And like I said, it's a happy ending. I like happy endings. I like rags to riches story. So I hope you enjoy it. If you'd like a copy of this book, you can go to my webpage, clauddiamond.com, or just go on zoomclaude.com or give me a call, 970-281-5151. Thanks a lot. Take care. Because nobody deserves success more than you good people. Thank you.